Do you like illusions?
Something like this?
Then stick around, because today we're gonna create this amazing photo manipulation illusion. What's up y'all, my name is Rens. I'm a surreal digital artist from the Netherlands, and today we're gonna create a fun and cool photo manipulation. But not just any photo manipulation, we are gonna create a mind-boggling photo manipulation illusion. All right, now let's jump into Affinity Photo and let me show you how this is done. All right, so we've jumped into Affinity Photo, and this is the photo that I want to apply the portrait illusion effect on. Now, as you can see, this is a simple portrait that I took of myself, and I actually shot two. So this is the first one, I called it original front, and then we have a second one, which is from the exact side of my face, which I called the original side image. All right, so we're gonna use both of these images to create this fun illusion effect. Now, the first thing that we want to do is we want to mask out the front portrait face, let's say, or we want to mask out the background. So how to do this? We can do this in two ways. We can select the original front layer, and we can either start selecting my face or we can start selecting the background. So either way is fine. And let me just select my face. So I'm gonna press W on the keyboard to select my selection brush tool, and I'm gonna simply brush over my face and my beanie and a part of my body. So let's do that right over here. Let's select my ear, let's select my beard as well as we can, which is still growing strong. And I think this looks pretty good. So now, of course, because I have this funny fuzzy beard hairs going on, I want to refine my selection. So I'm gonna go up to my context toolbar and I'm gonna hit refine. And I'm gonna simply brush over the parts that I want Affinity Photo to have a closer look at. And that's basically just where my beard is. And let's do that on the other side as well. We're actually not gonna use this side, but it's so easy to make a nice selection anyway. So let's do it quickly. Now you can see that I missed a little part of my ear. So I want to select my foreground adjustment brush, and I'm gonna brush in right over here. And as you can see, Affinity Photo will make a better selection of my ear. All right, now, if you want to have a different look at your preview, you can go down here in the dialog box and you can switch the preview to anything. So you can look at it at a black background, you can look at it at a white background, or you can look at black and white. And as you can see, this looks pretty, pretty good to me. So I will simply hit apply for now. Now we've turned it into a selection, I actually want to mask out the background. So we're gonna go to the layers panel and we're gonna hit the mask icon. And there we have our masked out portrait, let's say. Now I want to do the same with the other picture, but first I want to line things up. So I'm gonna enable or show the original side layer, and I'm gonna reduce the opacity to about 50%. So something like this. And now I'm gonna press V to select the move tool, and I'm gonna position this face right about here, so that I'm gonna look at my lips right over here. I want my lips to align, and I want my nose to align, and I basically want my eye to align as well. But I'm gonna use I'm gonna increase the size a little bit so that it there's my lip, by the way, so I have to put it, position it right around here. And I want to make sure that this also aligns pretty well. So this looks pretty good to me. Let's see, my nose aligns pretty, pretty well, and my eye also aligns, and my eyebrows. So this is gonna work pretty fine. So I'm gonna leave it like right here. Now I'm gonna increase the opacity to back to 100%. And now I basically want to do the same thing. So I'm gonna press W on the keyboard, and I'm gonna make a selection of the side of my face in this case, and also my beautiful beard, of course, and my mustache and everything as well. Now, same thing, I want to refine the selection. So I'm gonna hit the refine button in the context toolbar. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit, and I'm gonna brush over the parts that I want Affinity Photo to have a closer look at. So that's gonna be somewhere around here. These hairs right over here, this part, and of course my super awesome beard right over here. All right, so there we have both faces masked out and we've aligned them already. So now the next thing that I want to do is I want to apply this mask of the side of my face to the front face, let's say. So I want to load my mask, and how to do this, I want to hold command and I'm gonna click the mask of the original side layer. And as you can see, we will load the mask like so. And then what we want to do is we want to go to the front. We can actually hide this for now. We will go select the original front layer, whoops, like so, and we will hit the mask icon once again. So let's do that right now. And you can see that in Affinity Photo, we can actually stack up masks. So we cannot only use one mask per layer, but we can actually use multiple masks per layer. So now, as you can see, we've got two masks on one and the same image, and that looks pretty, pretty cool to me already. Now let's press Command D to deselect, and there are some things that we have to fix. As you can see, there are some mustache hairs in near my lips, which I want to delete, let's say. And there's something going on right over here that I also want to fix in a bit. But first, let's create a background. So how to create a background? I'm gonna do that by using a fill layer. So let's go up here to layer, so to the menu bar, let's go to layer, and let's click on new fill layer. Now, by default, this is gonna be a solid white color, but I don't really want a solid white colored background. I want to create an elliptical gradient, so I'm gonna hit the drop-down menu right over here, and I'm gonna select elliptical. Now, as you can see, because I have snapping turned on, you can see it right over here, this little magnet icon. You can see that the gradient will snap to the grid, which is something I do like in this case. So I want to snap to the middle, and I'm simply gonna click and drag to the top of my canvas. Now, this actually looks like a radial gradient. However, if you hold Control on Mac, and I'm not really sure which key you should use on Windows, so if you know that, please leave it down below in the comments. So if I hold Control on my Mac, I can select one of these handles, and I can actually change this from a radial gradient into an elliptical one. So I'm gonna drag this one till right about, let's say about here. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. I'm gonna hold Control, and I'm gonna stretch this one even further. Now, you can see that we've got a nice white color at the center of our document, which is something I do like. However, I want to darken the side a little bit, so I'm gonna select this handle right over here. I'm gonna double click the color picker, and I'm gonna decrease the lightness to about 50%, or 50 to the value 50, let's say. Now, this looks pretty nice to me, so I'm gonna close this, and I want to make sure that my background layer is all the way at the background, obviously. So let's double click this one and let's call it background. Oh, just quickly, if you've been getting value out of this tutorial already, don't forget to give it a like. And if you want to help me grow as a channel, then feel very free to subscribe to my channel. It would mean the world to me. Now let's jump right back into the tutorial. So now we have a nice background to look at, and now we can fix some things. Now, of course, we want to change the perspective of the nose, but first let me fix this part near my beard. So how I want to do this, I want to make a selection of my front face, let's say. So I'm gonna disable these both layer masks, and I want to make a selection of my beard. So I'm gonna press W on the keyboard, and I'm gonna make a nice selection right around here. And obviously you do understand that if you don't have a beard, this effect is gonna be way easier to apply, but I just wanna show you that it's also possible when you do have a beard. So I want to refine my selection. So I'm gonna go to the context toolbar and I'm gonna hit refine, and I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm simply gonna brush over my beard to make a nice selection of it. So let's do that right now. And I think this is gonna look pretty fine. All right, so there we go. We've got a nice selection. So now I can simply hit apply, and now we have my beard selected. So now I can show my masks again. And now you can see that we made a nice selection of my beard. Now I have my beard selected, but I want to invert my selection so that I have everything selected except my beard. So let's press Command Shift I to invert the selection. Now I have inverted my selection, which you cannot really see, but if I would go into my second mask, the second mask that I created on my original front layer, I press B on the keyboard to select my brush tool, and I would increase the opacity and the hardness quite a bit. You can see that I can actually mask out the excess pixels that I don't really need. Now, there's this thing. I want to keep kind of the line of my neck right around here. So I'm gonna try to simulate that. So I'm gonna disable my original side layer, and I'm basically just gonna draw something like this, which is probably something how my neck would be. And I'm gonna simply brush out all the rest. So let's brush over this part, because this we don't really need anymore. And there we go. So let's fix my neck a little bit. So I press X on the keyboard to toggle to white. Let's fix it a little better. So maybe something like so would look fine. And let's press Command D, and let's press Command 0 to zoom out. And there you have it. So let's see the before. This was the before, kind of, and this is the after. All right, so the next thing that I want to do is I want to change the perspective of my nose, and I also want to get rid of these hairs, by the way. So let's do that first, quickly. Let's press X. Let's select the right mask. Let's select black as a foreground color. And we're simply gonna brush out these hairs, because we don't really need hairs growing out of our lips, obviously. And maybe we can erase these as well. These don't really look nice, but I'll just leave them like they are for now. Let's just keep it. Maybe I want to make them black, but we'll see. All right, so we fixed this part. Maybe I want to fix my mustache a little better, because it kind of looks ridiculous right now. So let's fix this a little better, something like so. And now I want to fix the perspective of my nose. Now, we can basically do the same thing. We already have our original side layer still here. I'm gonna make it active, and I want to create a black layer mask. So I'm also gonna stack masks on this image right over here, and I'm gonna do that by using a black layer mask. So how to create a black layer mask? You want to hold the Alt or Option key on the keyboard, and you want to hit the mask icon. And as you can see, we've created a new layer mask right below here, and you can see that the whole face disappeared. Now, what we can do to reappear it, or to conceal it again, is by using a white brush. So I'm gonna press X on the keyboard to select a white brush. I'm gonna increase the brush size a little bit, and now you can see that I can brush over the nose, and there we have the side of my nose again. Now, I don't want this kind of wrinkle thing, so I'm gonna brush this part out as well. And I'm gonna use a black brush, so I press X to switch back to black. And I'm gonna use a soft round brush with a low opacity, and I'm kind of gonna blend this all together. So I'm gonna simply brush over this really nicely, and there we have a nice transition from both images, or a nice blending of both images. All right, I want to make this one black as well, so we can do this with the same mask. Actually, I can use my white brush, I can increase the opacity, and I will brush over this part once to turn it into black hairs instead of skin colored hairs. And now I want to change one last thing, and that is the perspective of my beanie. So now you can see the beanie has the perspective of my front face, let's say, but I also want to use the perspective of my side face, which is this one right over here. So I'm gonna use this same mask, and I'm gonna use a white brush as a foreground color, and I'm simply gonna brush right over here to create the effect that the beanie maybe increase the hardness a little bit, and that the beanie is as a side perspective. So something like this looks pretty good to me. Now I want to do the same thing. Let me fix this a little better. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna use a soft round brush with a low opacity, and I'm simply gonna blend this in a little better. So I'm gonna use black as a foreground color, and I'm simply gonna brush over this a couple of times, not too much, so that it just blends a little better with the rest of the image. Do you like illusions? Like, shit.